say that, I was pretty much, my life was pretty much just kind of one phase. It was just basketball, for professionally and almost socially, you could say, until I was 45, when I met my wife. I had known her before. I had actually coached her in Sweden. She played on the Swedish basketball national team. So we had known each other. And then we got together, and when I returned to Sweden, I was in, you know, I've been around, I was in Sweden originally in the 70s. Yep. In the 80s, I went back to Sweden. I left, I coached 1 year in the States, and then I came back and I was back in Sweden again. Then I left, I met her at that time, and then I left to Belgium for 1 year in Ostend. Right, and then I was in Germany for 6 years, and after Germany, then I went back to Sweden for 3 years, and at the end of that stay, I made contact again with Belgium, with Aalst, and then Aalst a year. But during that time, my last years in Sweden, it was the late 90s, we got together then, and got married, and started a family. We had to start right away because of my age. I couldn't be much older and start a family. And we have 2 children, and we had decided by the time they started school, we really wanted to find a place that we liked. And we were in Aalst in 99, 2000, just for 1 year, and for many different reasons we left. But we went back to Germany for a while, and the people in Aalst that we really got along with well ended up taking over the club and became the management of the club, and they asked me to return. And that's how we had decided once the kids started school, my wife's Swedish and of course I'm an American, so we're trying to find a place where we thought we would be most comfortable as a family, and both of us really liked Belgium. A lot to do with our experience at Aalst. So that's how we returned here. And I would say after I became 45, my life became much more, I would say,
settled,
not only settled, but it became the priority, of course, professionally was basketball, but my overall life priority, of course, is my family. And, you know, that was, and we've been able to kind of do both while we've been here. And it's worked out well. We've been here now. This will be our 9th year. One of the biggest strengths I've had is I've been able to really package all the positive sides of the club. I mean, I give a lot of credit to the management also, because they give them nice places to stay, they take care of their players, and all those things are very important, you know. That part of it, of course, we have a full gym. That's important. And now after a few years, we've also been able to take younger players, and agents can see that they often move from our club onto bigger things. Although the economy is now going around Europe, sometimes people are looking at Aalst as now more of a final destination, as a place to go rather than a stepping stone. Still, some of course use it as a stepping stone. But also, again, because of the management, people are paid on time. And these are all things that before were kind of just taken for granted. People expected that, and nowadays it's a real plus. So all these parts of it, I think, have something to do with it. And whether it's true or not, agents and players, we have a reputation in our club of making players better, or at least highlighting their strengths. You know, if that has to do with my coaching or not, that can be debated, but they come, they showcase themselves, they get better, and they all love playing. You know, when I'm not going to tell you who, but when we had the injury to Jason, for example, I had 3 ex-players that contacted me within days that wanted to come back. And this is the kind of reputation we have. People, even the ones that have left on to bigger things and made more money, said the best time they had, many of them, was their time in Aalst. So whatever that part of it is, and I think it's not due to just me or one person. I also am very fortunate because I have a supportive cell that really knows what they're doing and gives me really good advice. And I've got Frank and Tish, who are, in my mind, the two best guys in Belgium to have behind you. So I've got a lot of support that way, and it's worked. Whatever we're doing has worked pretty well for us. And then we have a style. I like to play. I think you want to do whatever you have to do to win. That's your main objective as a coach. But we have 2,000 people that come to the gym. And of course you'll have fans that will want to see more tactical things and more, cerebral type of basketball. But we have to entertain our fans. So we have to play a type of basketball, and we're not always able to do it, but we have to try to put a team together from the beginning that is going to be something that is going to play attractive type of basketball. I think that's all part of the mystique of Alst and why fans come to see it. So it's something as a coach I believe you have to take into consideration. I like answering questions. I try to be honest. I hope that's something that the fans have noticed whenever I've... But Trevor Huffman was a very special point guard.
Yep.
And I think Derek Ravio, he's only here 1 year, but has, potential and has done very well this season. He has that kind of possibility to have the same kind of impact. But I would say Trevor at that spot there. Lojewski was excellent at the wing position. I think Ryan Thompson, the player we have now, along with Lojewski, would be two of the best wings. And Jason was just starting to scratch the surface of what he could do. I think he would have maybe been in that mix with those guys. And there's going to be people I forget too. At the four position, we had a lot. Damian Cantrell was for sure a winner, a special player for us. Mike Doyle at the four position was very special, and of course Copeland. So you have three guys there that are fighting out all of it, and then the center position, Chris Young's been very strong for us. Darren Anglin, before was that we had a pretty good year with Stefan Paley. So there's quite a few guys, Trevor, and I would say Matt, Chris Copeland, those guys, and maybe Ryan Thompson. Hopefully, Well, I think it's kind of, when you talk about, especially that thing about other offers and stuff, I think it's kind of self-serving. I don't really like that when coaches say that. I was, for this situation this year, I was looking for possible options because I really expected this season to be the last season. That just was my mindset. I was kind of focused on that because I had been quite a while here in Okapi. But when the club came to me, and I think for a coach, you're always going to have your, people that feel one way or the other about you as a coach. But when the people that really know the financial situations, where the sponsors stand, along with what a lot of the fans think, are going to be committee members because they hear it from all sides. And they really are the ones that know the bottom line, both sportively, financially, and everything. So it was very flattering for me that they came and said they would like to extend me. It really, of course, everybody wants to feel wanted, and I've always liked the people here,
yeah.
And management, and of course fans and players. But so I was somewhat flattered, and I was kind of taken aback. I was a little bit surprised by it all, and I was. Once I started thinking about it, I was started saying to myself, well, where else would I, where would I be more happy? And of course, big thing is I had my family, I had to talk to them, and they were all positive about staying. So once they said that they would like to stay, I started thinking, more in depth about the situation here. And really, it's, after this amount of time, I am a member of this club. You know, I'm transplanted. I'm not born in Aalst or anything, but and maybe I'm not your typical Belgian or your typical, but I am an Aalst supporter also. Now, you know, I will be, I guess, forever. Mm-hmm. And I've coached so long. What's my ambition? You know, if I was to leave Aalst, where would I want to go? I'd want to go to a club that I think is run correctly, that treats me fairly, that is, you know, stable. And I was already there. Yeah. Well, obviously, I like them or I wouldn't be here. You know, I like people with passion. I think, you know, there's, as a coach, you're going to get both sides of that. You're going to get the negative and positive side of it. But I'd rather have them passionate and negative than not caring. Yeah. So I like the engagement of the fans and the passion for the team.
Even the criticism that sometimes comes with it, although you've been coached two, three times, coach of the year, 3 times. But still, you know, there is some...
Yeah, nobody likes criticism. No. Nobody likes it. But tell me where you can go where you're not going to get it. It's not going to happen. And like I said, it's more maybe heavier or stronger or more aggressive in Aalst, but that's because there's more passion and there's more interest. And even the people that don't like me as a coach or don't understand me as a coach or want a new coach, at least they're passionate about the team, you know? I mean, sometimes their own opinions, I think, are things they like to express and like to show their own knowledge, but that's part of the enjoyment of sports. It's the same if I watch baseball, I like baseball, and I will have comments on why did they play that guy instead of that guy, and what is the coach doing now, and that's just sports, that's part of the deal, and I like the passion of it, and of course, I also like the fans that support me, too, you know.
Shout, I'm talking to you, come on.
You know, my goal is always to try to get to the finals of both the competition and the cup, and then hopefully have some margins on our side and get another trophy. Our big issue always has been at the end of the seasons, at the end of every season. I hate this because I hate coaches talking about injuries and possible injuries. If we're completely healthy, I think we can beat anybody. By the end of the season, we just don't have the resources to bring in and replace people that if they're missing, you know, we have to. We can compete in a day against anybody, and you have to focus on who you have and not who's missing. But when you look at the big picture. I think we can beat anybody when we're healthy. Now we know we don't have Jason. Mm. We won't have him the rest of the season, so we won't. But what are we going to look like now when we get everybody going? We'll have to see. So it's a little bit of a unclear scenario. But the team that we finished, or almost finished the December with before Jason's injury, I thought was showing that they could beat anybody in the league.
Is there, last question, is there anything else you want to say to the fans of Okapi?
Well, I just, I hope that they understand that sometimes I'm not the as emotional person that you see as some other coaches. But there's a lot going inside, you know, my head. And somebody asked me, what is the secret of coaching Aalst? And I said, it's to win games and coach dumb. Because that way... the fans will put up with you because you're winning, and they can have a lot of things to complain about at the same time. But of course, I don't, and that's not all the fans, of course. But it's, I just try to do the best I job. I go to work. I put in an honest day's work. I make a lot of mistakes, and I will continue to do that. But I hope I do more good than bad. And I'm very grateful and thankful that everybody's put up with me as long as they have.
Yeah. And we'll put up another 2 years.
I hope so, you know, and well, I can now keep on doing the same effort. It doesn't matter if my contract's for 1 day or 2 years, they'll get the same effort out of me.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Dank u wel.